And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the man who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
Hey there, welcome to week two. So glad you're here with me again today. And guess what we're going to be having in a few days? You guessed it, the 4th of July. So I hope that you're decorating like Miss Grace has got our library decorated up here at the library. Come up and hopefully you'll get a chance to see us for too long. And like Miss Kim found some American books that you can check out and read and enjoy. And so what I'm going to do today is share a few of those and share a fun craft. You know, last week I talked about always being on the lookout. You never know where you're going to find some inspiration, something to read, something that you want to do. Some of you know, some of your parents, I had them as kindergartners because I have been teaching here at Brown County for quite a few years. And one thing that I miss about not teaching kindergarten anymore are the crafts. And so that's why I love summer reading and the fun stories and the creative things that sometimes I get a chance to do. And any of you ever seen an Oriental Trading, the little magazine that comes in the mail? Well, it had a lot of things for patriotic and a lot of fun stuff in there. And these two little hats caught my attention. So I'm going to help you show you how you can make one of these little hats just by having some of the things that you might have at home. And it's called a firecracker hat. If you want to order them through Oriental, you can, but we're going to make one for too long. So anybody doing anything fun? Remember, email me at the Brown County Public Library or call me, send me a text, draw me a picture, anything that I could share through social media. Mr. Richard has got things set up technology-wise, and Miss Grace is great about social media and all the things that she can share and do. So please communicate with us this summer and let us know what you're doing. So let's get started. And I want to start with A is for American. This is the book, and it's about an American alphabet. And when Miss Kim found some books for me, she and Miss Faye were looking when I got here this afternoon. And when I was looking at this story, it made me think all about the things. The song that I started today with was Lee Greenwood, Proud to Be an American. And that patriotic as something that I've always been, and proud to live in America because we're free to go to school, we're free to come to the library, we're free to get out and play outdoors, and so many things, so many freedoms that we have because we live in the USA, the United States of America. So let's begin here. We got A. Shout it from the highest hill that A is for America. B, the Battle of Bunker Hill was actually won by the British, but the American patriots fought so bravely that the battle became a rallying cry for the rest of the American Revolution. B is for the Liberty Bell. C is for the cities that reach into the blue, like Chicago, Cleveland, Charlotte, and Cincinnati do. And it's for the Constitution that guides us still today, the citizens of the United States of America. D is for Detroit and its shiny automobiles. It's called the Motor City, and it put the world on wheels. It's Dallas and it's Denver and Dover, Delaware. It's the Dakotas in December when snow is in the air. Takes you all across the United States. E is the elegant eagle soaring above the hill and the ever-flowing Everglades where egrets eat their fill. E is an endless echo in the Grand Canyon at dawn and Eureka. It's Thomas Edison turning the light bulb on. Grand Canyon, you ever been there? Great place, fun place to go. F, we celebrate, you guessed it, Independence Day on the 4th of July every year. The fireworks we display remind us of the rocket's red glare mentioned in our national anthem, the Star Spangled Banner. F is for the fireworks that fly on the 4th, from Fort Worth in the south to Fargo in the north. F is 50 fluttering flags and 50 license plates, 50 fine state capitals, and 50 United States. And I want to pause right here. The American flag is something to be proud of. And something that we say every day at school is the Pledge of Allegiance. And Miss Grace has a flag for us flying back behind. So I'm going to put my hand to my heart, and I want you to say the pledge with me. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Grand old flag. G is for gold rush that swept the Golden State and gave us California with its grand Golden Gate. H stands for Hemingway and Huckleberry Finn, hydraulic Hoover Dam, and so many Holiday Inns. Hot dogs in Hawaii, Henry Ford and his cars, heading home on Halloween with chocolate Hershey bars. Huckleberry Finn, those stories are told in Hannibal, Missouri. Great place to go, not too far away, and you can go see the cave where the adventures of Tom Sawyer were. I is indeed important, how America came to be. It's the idea that an individual can insist on being free. And I is for immigration and the immigrants who came from Italy, Ireland, or India were Americans all the same. Statue of Liberty, definitely put that on your bucket list. That's a great place in America if you ever get a chance to go. I was blessed to get to go a few years ago, and we didn't get to go all the way up in the top, but we did get to go up in the statue, and it's just an amazing experience. If you ever get to go to New York, make sure you go there. Up to J, from Jamestown to James Monroe, we need the letter J. If not for Thomas Jefferson, where would we be today? It's Jackson Hole, Wyoming, and the jiggle that Jell-O has. It's a jam session jumping with the music we call jazz. Jell-O Jigglers, that'd be something fun to make today. K, Kitty Hawk in Kansas and Kodiak Bears. King Kamehameha, Kellogg's Rice Krispie Squares. K is for two kinds of king, George III, who was defeated, and Martin Luther Jr., whom our troubled nation needed. Abraham Lincoln gets all of the letter L. It's elementary, you see. He held us all together, and at the same time, he set us free. His memorial in Washington makes him a giant of a man, or look upon a smaller one, a penny that you would hold in your hand. And guess what? You go over to Brown County Elementary School. I don't know if your teachers have ever taken you there. I used to take my kindergartners. There's a big rock, and it stands on the corner right out in front of the school. And back when Abraham Lincoln was running for public office, he had a debate with Douglas. And so there is a placard on there, and it says that marks the spot. And that tells us that in this area, Abraham Lincoln gave a debate speech there. So check it out. That's a good place in Brown County here. M, Mayflower, Minuteman, Motown, Manatee. M is Mickey Mantle, Mickey Mouse, Monopoly. M can seem so mighty when it's a river rolling by. M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-P-P-I, the Mississippi River. another fun way that we used to say it when I was a kid was M-I, crooked letter, I, crooked letter, I, humpback, I. That's how we used to describe the letters in Mississippi. In Norman Rockwell, Niagara Falls, A Night in New Mexico, New Orleans, A Native American, N is for Navajo, and Nassau and Neil Armstrong, who reached the moon to find that it was one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind. Now, back when we were still in school and I was helping some of my fifth graders with their science homework, they were exploring the planets, and this was one of the quotes that we had to find an answer for Mrs. Jensen's science class. So you never know when you're going to need those answers. Oh, the Old West, the OK Corral, the Old Oregon Trail, an old Henry Outlaw, an owl on a rail, Old Faithful, Old Glory, our flag, and good old Oreos. Anybody like those? An overlook in the Ozarks, where the occasional opossum goes. Ozarks, that's a place I used to go as a kid because that's where my grandma and my grandpa grew up farming. Pike's Peak and peanut butter, that's the letter P. Plymouth Rock and Pilgrims at Peril on the Sea. Rosa Parks, parades, popcorn in a pan. Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, where all of it began. One of the most popular snacks, popcorn. Q is for the quill that John Hancock used to place his quite creative signature in a most important space. It's for the American Quarter and the bobwhite quail and the quilts that kept the Quakers warm in a Pennsylvania gale. John Hancock was the president of the Second Continental Congress, which drew up the Declaration of Independence. And this is his large and unique signature that you will see in history. A remote reach of the Rockies, the reflection of Mount Rainier, the regal ridge of Mount Rushmore, the ride of Paul Revere, the Roosevelts, Franklin and Teddy, Babe Ruth, rock and roll, Rosie the Riveter, the Rio Grande, and remember the Alamo. Lots of history in this book. Stand and salute the stars and stripes, a symbol to celebrate, a stripe for each of the colonies and a star for every state. Susan B. Anthony, Sierra Nevada, a steam locomotive train, Sitting Bull and Samuel Clemens, better known as, there in Hannibal, Mark Twain. A T as tall as Texas for Thanksgiving and telephone, Harry S. Truman, Harriet Tubman, and trips to the Twilight Zone. Times Square on New Year's Eve, a tasty Tootsie Roll, turning timber into a tall and towering totem pole. And I would just have a thought here for Brown County. For T, letter T, we could add Tasty Treat. Good place to go for ice cream. U takes us up to Utah, unafraid of an upcoming storm. It's undeniably Ulysses S. Grant in his Union uniform. It's also Uncle Tom's Cabin, which helped us understand the uncommon things we must uphold for dear old Uncle Sam. And this is a famous book, Uncle Tom's Cabin. V is for the veterans and the valor they displayed in vying for vital victories and the sacrifices they made. V is for Virginia and Vermont and Vikings too. It seems they got here long before Columbus was able to. W, Wheeling, West Virginia, Walt Disney, a wagon train, World War I and World War II, the World Series, and John Wayne. W stands for Washington, who wintered at Valley Forge. City, state, and president, all named for him. Mr. George. The letter X should remind us of the importance of Election Day, when all Americans, rich and poor, are allowed to have their say. Some were told they couldn't vote if they couldn't write their name, so they signed the ballot with a letter X, and it counted just the same. Free elections are one of the most cherished and important practices of a democracy. Why? Yellowstone National Park is located mostly in Wyoming, but extends into Montana and Idaho as well. Yosemite National Park is located in the Sierra Nevada Mountains of California. Another great place to go. Why can make you hungry, as Yogi Bear has shown. Out yonder you'll find why. And another place here in Brown County for why would be, you guessed it, the YMCA. And I want to give a shout out to our Y campers, and they're not at the YMCA this summer, but they are out at the Brown County Middle School still having YMCA summer camp. So, hi guys, I'm glad that you could join us today. And here we are to Z. Z is for Zane Grey, who wrote stories about the West. Z is also for zip codes, but I think that I like best for Z to remind us of Whitcomb Judson. As clever as could be, he gave us the magical zipper in 1893. That's a history fact that I don't think I remember ever hearing. So, Whitcomb Judson with the zipper. The United States Post Office added zip codes to mailing addresses in 1963. And really think about that, really wasn't that long ago. And anybody know what our Brown County zip code is? When you go to write a letter, you give your name, you give your address, which is a street or a rural address, and you would put Mount Sterling, Illinois. If you live in Mount Sterling, it's 62353. Versailles, Illinois, 62378. And Timewell is 62375. So if you're going to write me a letter this summer, that's another way you could communicate with me. You would use your zip code. So think of that too. If you write me a letter, I promise I would be your pen pal and write you back. So that is A is for America. And have you ever sang the song, The Star-Spangled Banner? Can you try singing that with me? And the words are in the back of this one. Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave. Bet you've heard that at ball games before. So, A is for America. Come up, check it out, the library. So, ready for a craft time? Like I said, this is one thing that I do miss about kindergarten. Gigi the giraffe has my hat on that I made at home before I came up. Piglet's here with us today. Piglet has a nice, happy, smiley face. Piglet loves to be at the library listening to the stories. So, God bless the USA. And here is my firecracker hat that I'm going to plan on wearing for the 4th of July. I'll switch hats with Gigi. And here we go. Does this look like firecrackers? And it says Happy 4th. And these are some things that you might have at home. And so what I did, I just started, I made my poster and I had some extra scrap paper from my printer. So this is just real flimsy paper. And I cut it into strips, just like this. And then I took my pieces. Now I have a stapler. If you don't have a stapler at home, you could also use tape, okay? So tape it together or staple it together. It seems like when I think back to kindergarten, we always had a hat for every occasion. And so then you wrap it around, and if it's not long enough, then you just keep adding strips to make it the length that you need. And you might have to get somebody a little taller than you, wrap it around, find the width of your head. Oop, I pulled mine off. Find the width that you need. And voila, there's your, there it is for your head, okay? Now the next thing I did was I used my marker, or you can use crayon or pencil or colored pencils, whatever you want. And I put Happy 4th on mine. So just write whatever you want to write. Happy 4th. And then exclamation points. If you want to put some lines for firecrackers or dots. I used to like to decorate with dots when I was a kid. And I would use, if I had red, white, and blue, especially red and blue, I would dot wherever I wanted to dot. And that just makes it look like it's bursting with firecrackers, right? We're all looking forward to those on the 4th of July that helps us celebrate living in America. Another thing that I happen to have at home, they're called fuzzy sticks or chantilly sticks. So when I just took one of those, and you can make it whatever shape. The fun thing about these, make it look like a squiggly worm, like the squiggly worm, that little pink fuzzy worm we had in our first story back when I read to you last week. You remember that? So whatever shape you want to bend them and make them, okay? All kinds of fun things. And then, once again, I just taped mine on. See how that stays on there, wherever you want to put it? And then one other fun thing that I had, if you can see on mine, I had these really sticky stars that are shiny and my hearts, because I love America and I love the 4th of July. But if you don't have these sticker things, I believe they probably came from a craft store or Oriental Trading. See, I just stuck them on there. But if you don't have those, once again, use your markers or your crayons and just draw a star, okay? And it doesn't have to be a perfect star. Or you can just do dots or whatever you want to do. And if you don't know how to make a star, ask somebody to help you or Google it, okay? Always time to learn something fun and new. So go ahead, make you a fun 4th of July hat so that you and I can be celebrating together. And don't forget to send me a picture, okay? So, go out and enjoy those. Have a fun time outside with your family. Have a picnic. Maybe you can roast some hot dogs, find a water slide, play bubbles, bags game. There's always something you can think of to do. Pitch and catch, croquet, ride your bike. Forgot about mentioning ride your bike. Jump a rope. Always something you can figure out to do. Read a good book, right? Okay, so there's a hat for Piglet. How's that? I wanted to share with you a few more of our our Independence Day books that we have that you can check out up here or get a chance to come up and read. One of them is Uncle Sam's America, A Parade Through Our Star-Spangled History. So if you like history, there's a lot more in this one. And another one is Paloma Wants to Be Lady Freedom. And when Miss Kim gave me this one and I was reading through it, it was very inspirational to me. And what I like about this one, it takes you to Washington, D.C. And this Washington Monument is actually what I created with my poster with all the fireworks going off for the 4th of July. So this has a lot of beautiful, looks like watercolor pictures in it. Takes you into the Capitol, and you can see all of the artwork and architecture. So remember I talked about the Statue of Liberty is on your bucket list? Make sure you add Washington, D.C. to your bucket list as well. Something very inspiring in front of this book that I wanted to read. Thank you for allowing me to see freedom through your eyes. You taught me to love America and appreciate the gift of citizenship. You inspire me to keep fighting for freedom and the American dream. Your service to our country fills my heart with pride. Your insight and honesty were invaluable, and we are a team. Freedom is never more than one generation away from extinction. We didn't pass it to our children in the bloodstream. It must be fought for, protected, and handed on for them to do the same. And that was a famous quote by one of our presidents, Ronald Reagan, who actually was from Illinois. And so remember, the 4th of July is about being an American and being free. And don't ever take that for granted. And so keep fighting for America. One last story I want to share with you is called Celebrate Independence Day. And this is also up here at the library. And this talks about our holidays. Today is Independence Day. Independence Day is the birthday of our country. We celebrate the United States on Independence Day. Independence Day happens every year on July 4th. Not today, but just in a few days, is July 4th. You'll see it on your calendar. We're going to celebrate. We will have a flag ceremony. We will need a flag. We raise the flag. It is way up high. And that's one thing that when you come downtown Mount Sterling, in front of the courthouse, out the cemeteries, all around, they will proudly raise the American flag. We say the Pledge of Allegiance. Here's some baseball players saying it before their game. Now it is time to celebrate. On Independence Day, we have a barbecue. Something fun and something to look forward to. Then we go and see the fireworks. The fireworks go bang. They are very pretty. When I see that page, I can hear myself oohing and aahing. Last 4th of July, we happened to be in Springfield, and we were up on the top of a hotel, and all around us, the north, south, east, and west, there were fireworks going off, and it was a pretty cool place to watch the fireworks. So hopefully we'll be seeing those for very soon. Happy Independence Day. So I hope you enjoyed your second week of summer reading here at the Brown County Public Library. And remember to go to browncountypubliclibrary.org. My email, sandy@browncountypubliclibrary.org. You can get on and get to your summer reading log. It's on the website. Miss Grace has everything up there and our YouTube links, because we have 6 more weeks coming to you for Summer Reading 2020. So drop me an email, drop off pictures, anything that you do here to the library, so that we can stay in touch and keep loving the library and loving America. So happy 4th and enjoy, and I will see you next week. And keep reaching out to us.